So are Australia, New Zealand and Canada actually independent countries? Today we'll answer this question. So hello everyone, namaste, annyeong haseyo, konnichiwa, salyu. This is Vishal and welcome to my channel Indica Central. So Australia, New Zealand are two prominent countries along with Fiji and Tuvalu who still feature the Union Jack on their flags. All these countries are Commonwealth countries. But there is something special about Australia, New Zealand and Tuvalu. They still have Queen Elizabeth II as their monarch, as their head of state. These are known as Commonwealth Realms, a term that is different from Commonwealth countries like India and Pakistan. So as of 2020, there are 16 Commonwealth Realms that are Antigua and Barbuda, Australia, Bahamas, Barbados, Belize, Canada, Grenada, Jamaica, New Zealand, Papua New Guinea, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Lucia, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Solomon Islands, Tuvalu and of course the UK. Now Commonwealth Realms are independent and sovereign states, but they are not republics. So as for Australia, New Zealand and Canada, it makes sense for them to have the British monarch as their monarch since they are predominantly European origin people dominated countries. But why do the others still have it? And what is the difference between a Commonwealth realm and a Commonwealth country? We'll keep all this for some other video. So today in this video, we'll discuss about three prominent countries and with special focus to Australia. So going back to history, Australia was first visited by Captain James Cook in 1768. And in 1788, the British government sent a fleet of ships and raised the Union Jack, making it a penal colony. This day, that is precisely 26th of Jan 1788, was marked as their National Day, called the Australia Day. So unlike India, Australia's National Day is not their day of independence, but their day of colonization. Now we all know that these three were British colonies. But in 1931, the British government passed the Statute of Westminster, which gave all three of them parliamentary independence, making them dominions. Now, please note that India was not a dominion, although this was demanded by freedom fighters like Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So the power of the British government to legislate for the central government of Australia ended. However, it still had the power to legislate for the Australian states and territories. So for example, in 1933, when Western Australia wanted to secede from Australia and they held a referendum which was successful, their state government sent these results to London and not Canberra and demanded that the British government make them a sovereign state. However, the British government rejected this, stating that it's an internal matter of Canberra. Now, to relinquish these remaining powers that the British government had, Australia passed an Australia Act in 1986. Similarly, Canada passed an Constitution Act in 1982 and New Zealand passed it in 1986. So this Australia Act declared Australia as a sovereign, independent and a federal state. Now I said these three countries are not republics, which means they do not have a president. Their head of state is the British monarch, which is currently Queen Elizabeth II. So her appointee in this respective country is the Governor General. This Governor General is appointed by the Queen on the advice of the Prime Minister of that country. The Prime Minister selects the Governor General, although he or she may consult the Queen. In Australia, until 1965, all the Governor Generals were British born. Similarly, Canada got its first Governor General born in Canada in 1952, and in New Zealand, it was in 1967. Also, until 1989, all the Australian Governor Generals were members of the Privy Council of the UK, which is a body which acts as the advisory to the British monarch. Now, in 1989, a referendum was held in Australia asking if the voters want to make Australia a republic. This yes block of the referendum was headed by the former Prime Minister, Mr. Malcolm Turnbull. However, this referendum was unsuccessful, with 54% of the population saying no. But had this been successful, Australia would have severed all the remaining links with the British monarch, making it a perfect, undoubted republic. Now, if you ask me my opinion, whether all these three countries are independent or still British colonies, so I would say yes, they are definitely very much independent. The only remaining power of the British Crown to select the namesake, the ceremonial Governor General, does not affect their independence in any way. they are still sovereign countries, members of the United Nations. And if you still doubt it, then how can you recognize India's independence of 1947? Because even after that, for 3 years, until India was made a republic, India still followed the Government of India Act of 1935, which was enacted in the British government time. Also, India had a British Governor General, Lord Mountbatten, for a few months. So I hope this video was of some help and it was helpful to answer your question, teach you something new. If you like this video, please press a like button, please share and subscribe to my channel Indica Central. Also, please press the bell icon to get the latest updates of all our videos. Thank you. Thanks for watching.